Do you remember the last match I had before I returned to WWE? It was with you. And I remember what you told me after that match. Do you remember? You said I was going to be a future world champion. And I've done it twice. Now I'm going to tell you in front of the entire world. I've seen what people are saying. It doesn't matter who comes back. I've seen the gifts, I've seen the jokes. Screw it. You put your head down, you keep working, keep doing what you're doing, and you're gonna be the first member of your family to raise that championship. You are gonna finish the story. But not before I finish mine. This ain't about anybody else right now. This is about you and me. And since you're following my footsteps, I'm gonna give you some advice. Just be yourself, man. You don't have to wear the suits all the time. You're not running for office. You don't have to use all the big words, like a thesaurus with your word of the day toilet paper, and the biggest one of all, just don't smile all the time. You got that big, dumb smile. And I can say that because I did it too. I felt like even when I was angry, frustrated, sad, I had to be that beacon of light for the roster. I had to be that leader. I had to put that big, dumb smile in my face. Wipe it off, mate. Be the real Cody. And if anybody has an issue with the real Cody, they can step up to you and you drop them in their arse.
Since we're talking about stepping up, I assure you, Drew, this is not an act. I smile when I come out here because this is what I love. I appreciate the opportunities I've got because I made them for myself. You're right, we are very similar, similar career paths, but the difference right now is I am thankful, I am grateful, I cherish, I relish my second chance, and you are just standing here complaining about yours. So if you want to settle this in the Royal Rumble, I sure as hell will give you something else to complain about. And another thing, you keep mentioning this last match that we had. You told the story about the last match between you and I. Let me ask you something about it. Who won?
Woods and Kaiser pounding the heck out of each other. And now Woods with the upper hand.
Woods refusing to be denied tonight.
And giving Kaiser a little of his own medicine.
Woods simply a man on a mission.
Xavier Woods sends Kaiser up over the top rope. And now Woods gonna fly, drop kick, lifts Kaiser up and over our announce table, and Kaiser hit hard.
Oh, what a horrible landing for Ludwig Kaiser.
You could have moved your chair for him.
I have to focus on getting myself out of the way.
And now Kaiser trying to do the same thing he did to Kofi last week. Woods was ready. And now dumps Kaiser on the announce table. And now hammering away at Kaiser. And Kaiser trying to rip the eyes, thumb in the mouth of Woods. Woods with a kick, and this is broken down out here at ringside. And now Woods with a chair to Kaiser. A little bit of payback. The official had no choice but to call for the bell. Woods using the chair as a weapon, and it forced the disqualification. So Woods said, well, why not? And now Woods with a steel chair in hand, and Kaiser with a kick to the chair off the face of Woods.
Well, the anger and fury simply boiled over in this one. And once again, it's a member of New Day that has come a cropper at the hands of the vengeful Ludwig Kaiser.
And Kaiser's not done yet. He drags Xavier Woods to his feet, and now he's gonna do to Woods what he did to Kingston last week.
It's an action replay. It worked perfectly last time. God, someone stop this.
Xavier Woods is defenseless, but now makes it back to his feet, and he's able to take out Kaiser.
Woods needed everything in his soul to summon up the energy to stand up there. And damn, did he need it.
This rivalry between Imperium and New Day has been taken to another level tonight. Xavier Woods with a steel steps in hand. He's going to try to injure. He's going to try to maim Kaiser, who ducks out of harm's way. And I love Ludwig Kaiser trying to escape the wrath of Xavier Woods.
Kaiser looked like he'd seen a ghost.
As Kaiser escapes out of the WWE Universe.
Two can play in that game, Ludwig.
The problem with this, Wade, is nothing was settled tonight.
Excuse me, Xavier. Can you explain to us where your emotions were at a moment ago when we saw
Where do you think they were at, Byron? You saw what he did last week to Kofi? I'm not gonna...
Oh!
That's
Kaiser!
Come on, Jake, calm down.
Get him out of here.
Guys, get him out of
here.
I told you!
Hey, pump the brakes, slow down. Get something more manageable.
Yeah, but shouldn't it be applauded that you want to take on these challenges, Wade, and try to prove your worth to the group?
What's the definition of insanity? Doing the same thing over over and over again, expecting a different result.
Well, Tozawa's a tremendous athlete, and he's not going to back down from a challenge.
I don't doubt that at all. I'm an admirer of Tozawa, but I think there is a limit to everyone's potential. But you know what? I may be made to eat my words. I would be surprised.
Yeah, the quickness from Tozawa. Not going to outpower Ivar, however. And...
Oh, goodness.
Man, that Tozawa was... with a tremendous counter, and Tozawa's feeling it now.
Effectively using Ivar's power against him.
And he does. He's able to rip the shirt tonight.
It took about 10 minutes. That's the problem. And in that 10 minutes, Ivar.
Spinning slam by Ivar.
Takes the Tozawa on a round the world
slam. Oh, no, cross body.
And a sternum crush. It's just angered Ivar. That's the problem. I like the flurry. I like the attempt. But this was inevitable. And once again, the big man seems to be going skyward.
And now Maxine on the apron begging Ivar, or trying to distract Ivar, nonetheless.
Who would not be distracted? Oh!
Tozawa kicked to the face. Ivar is in trouble, trying to keep his balance. Tozawa now, top rope, sunset flip, powerbomb, stacks up Ivar.
No way!
Got it! Tozawa with the win!
Here is your winner, Akira Tozawa!
Uh-oh. And now Valhalla blasting Maxine, blaming Maxine for the distraction that may have cost Ivar the match.
Tozawa got flattened in the process, such as the power and force of Valhalla.
And now Tozawa trying to come to the aid of Maxine and runs into that spin kick by Ivar. Valhalla punishing Maxine.
Well, that was a Pyrrhic victory for the Alpha Academy.
A fish hook to the jaw of Maxine. And then a headbutt. And Valhalla and Ivar laying waste to the members of the Alpha Academy.
Sometimes in life, when you win, really you lose.
Well, Tozawa picked up the victory tonight, but at what cost? 300 pounds as that weirdo Valhalla looks on. The Doomsault!
So here we stand. Two very different people with two very similar journeys. Both two women from foreign lands who dreamt of coming over here and becoming the very best to ever do it. Both spent years meandering, trying to figure it out. Both went from being afterthoughts at WrestleMania 1 year to becoming the faces of the industry the next. But there's a difference. one of us went on to win the main event of WrestleMania. The other did not. But there's another difference. One of us has a natural ability in this ring and a finesse that is unmatched. They have the strength of a bear. The other has the heart of a lion. And a relentlessness and a determination that is unmatched. So here we stand, the two very best to do it. But there's this voice in my head, this thing that keeps me awake, and it's asking and it's questioning and it's saying to me, I think you might be better than me. But I need to prove that you're not. And to do that, I need to take that title from you. And to do that, I need to win the Royal Rumble. I need to point to the sign. I need to declare at WrestleMania it will be Mommy versus the Man.
Becky, there's only one other person that wants you to win the Royal Rumble match more than yourself. And that's me. I'll see you at WrestleMania.
So again, the matchup's underway. Again, Miz was fired up about this. He said, we make magic when we're awesome truth, that we've never been tag team champs, so maybe we can add that to our list of great moments.
Well, our truth is WWE's resident space cadet. And he wasn't even supposed to get involved in this
matchup.
Damian Priest.
Again, being a bad journalist, as you always are, you're making things up. Priest said, don't tag in. He didn't say anything about starting the match.
You wrote the book on bad faith journalism, Michael Cole.
In our truth now, took out Finn Balor, who he believes is his teammate. Now he's upset about it. Balor now, double leg takedown of Truth and stomping away down on R-Truth.
Yeah, I've noticed Priest has seemingly warmed somewhat to R-Truth of late. The same cannot be said about Finn Balor.
Again, you said it earlier, you hand somebody money, they'll warm you.
Remember?
Truth, tag, here comes Miz. And Miz now with a clothesline. And the Miz, who I said earlier, is so excited about this matchup tonight, an opportunity to maybe knock off the tag champs.
Well, maybe he's as nuts as R-Truth then.
Miz ducks underneath, and now, right here in front of us, Damian Priest right off the announce table. And again, Priest over and down and out.
Miz might win this one on his own. He's the freshest man in the matchup, finally getting in there. And he's got all the momentum.
Get out of the way. Priest trying to get out of the announce table as Miz now goes into the cover, hooks the leg on Balor, and a kick out.
And if I was Miz, I would not tag in Truth at any point if you actually want to win this matchup. Got to do it on your own from here, pal.
And now Miz looking perhaps for a skull-crushing finale takedown by Balor.
Balor just too quick.
Tag made, and here comes Truth.
Miz knew very little about that tag, but perhaps Truth back on track.
Whoa! Scissor kick right to the back of the neck, and R-Truth can't believe he took out his own partner.
You trying to join us or not? What happened to this?
And from behind, Balor trying to take out Truth and caught him with a heel kick. And Damian Priest, so much for the teammate, south of heaven.
That went south in a hurry.
And Balor will crawl into the cover for the Judgment Day win. Cover now on Rollins. Hook of the inside leg of Mahal, and into Shear pays off. Again, Rollins hit the pedigree, but he didn't get all of it because of the bad knee. And then Wade, he couldn't capitalize quick enough.
That's what cost him. That's what happens when you burn the candle at both ends. Your body starts breaking down on you.
And Rollins, top rope, going to take out into Shear.
Seth Rollins fighting battles on many fronts. But the most important battle of all is for the World Heavyweight Championship.
Somebody hold Mahal. Moves out of harm's way as Rollins went for the splash.
Well, that diversion when he launched himself onto
Sonya
on
back
the outside.
To his feet. With both men down, Damian Priest maybe wondering if this is the time, if this is his opportunity to finally cash in the contract.
Lots of...
But look who's here.
You want to keep running over? You want to keep running your mouth? What, you think he's going to get my business? Okay.
Boom! Next week's come early, Cole!
And Priest and McIntyre unloading on each other. Remember, McIntyre blamed Priest for trying to cash in Money in the Bank and costing him a world championship opportunity.
A heavyweight
slugfest. Oh, and a cheap shot.
Referee didn't see that. He was distracted by Drew and Priest. Am I up?
In the hall, trying to take advantage. Rolls up the champion for the title. And a kick out by Rollins. Into Shear delivering a cheap shot to Rollins when the official was dealing with McIntyre and Priest on the other side. In the hall, almost stole the championship.
There are bullseyes all over the body of the champ now. And Jinder knows it. Jinder smells blood.
Yeah, Mahal realizes this is his chance. This is his opportunity. Oh, no. Steel chair. Tossed into Mahal.
Seth Rollins wasn't born yesterday.
Oh, the briefcase off the face of Rollins. Mahal with the Coloss. You gotta be kidding me. Not like this. Rollins kicks it too.
Oh my, what a sequence, Cole. That is exactly how Jinder Mahal won the WWE Championship.
And Veer and Sangha are livid.
Veer and Sangha are getting tossed out of here.
And Mahal going once again for the Coloss. Rollins able to roll through. Stopped by Rollins. Cover. Rollins retains the championship.
Born to be the greatest of all time. This is where I draw the line. Can't stop my shine. They know it's my time. Let the world know I've arrived. I'm on the rise. Unstoppable.